So we traveled to the Mind Body Spirit Festival and interviewed all sorts of awesome and interesting people. If you haven't noticed, the discussion forums are on fire. There's just an enormous number of people who are responding and providing their own points of view. And so what we're gonna do is we are going to examine some extraordinary claims. So we talked about all sorts of different cognitive phenomena that are operating in terms of one-sided events, variable windows of time. We're gonna hand out a bunch of sheets to each table. Now these sheets represent a bunch of fairly strong claims about various things. What we want you to do is analyze those claims and see how you can approach a lot of the topics that we've talked about in this course to those. But don't just beat up on them, that's not the point of this exercise. What we want you to do is actually consider them as well. Consider whether there might be anything to them.
Get them to turn around and say you have like a 3-minute time period where you can say like within that duration, just like raise your hand or say now when you think I'm looking at your neck, or just some kind of like relatively controlled demonstration.
You could use like a whole heap of really big words and be like, and it's been shown to be linked with the availability heuristic as well as representative heuristic and all of these other things which are extremely validated with the scientific method.
Okay, we said Barnum statements because like they're really broad and it can apply to anything, so it's easy to kind of believe that.
I think it's the kind of thing that like you could test someone on and get like an idea of whether they can do it or not. Put someone down and if they say they can speed read, like prove it, but I don't know.
It seems really easy to test, but it's like, so why haven't they tested it? Why don't we have information that it has had? Like,
it depends what they're saying speed reading is though. Is speed reading just reading the words or is it actually remembering them?
You are asking those questions, you and Matt are asking those questions anyway, and they just give you cyclic answers that explain themselves in this little bubble but don't actually give any real explanation anyway. So if those answers are good enough for them, then it's the question of how do you break that?
He said think about the amount of times just you were thinking about calling your mum and then your mum calls you, and sort of just make them be really biased to these events.
I don't know if there's like a society, homeopathy society or something, but I might like send an email to them as well and see their response.